Hello everybody, I want to show a little collection of mimeographs and duplicators covering around 150 years of history of devices, allowing people doing copies of what they wrote. Of course, in 1874, that is the year of production of the first model I will present, the typography had been invented a long time before. But with these devices, anyone could make many copies of a piece of writing cheaply and easily. So these devices made it easier to spread ideas, news, but also more simple things like menus and worksheets, making life easier for many people. So typewriters permitted to write clearly and rapidly an idea. Mimeographs permitted to spread this idea. Some of them are engineering masterpieces made of many moving parts. Other devices are quite simple, but still very ingenious. Other of these copiers needs the complicated use of chemicals. It's an interesting point of view on this underestimated technology, and there is more variety than you think. For some of these devices, there is already a video on my channel. You find the link in the description. For the other devices in this video, I hope to do it soon. Let's start with this. It's the Zucatos papyrograph from around 1874. It's the earliest form of document reproduction technique known as stencil duplicating, invented in 1874 by Eugenio de Zucato. It's a wonderful piece, complete with the original accessories. One day I will make a video trying to duplicate a document with this method. I can do it because there is a manual in bad conditions and with some part missing, but most important parts are readable. This will not be easy because to duplicate a document there are 97 steps involving chemicals, special paper and other issues. You see, the copier actually is a group of bottles with chemicals and other boxes, still with chemicals and a press. In general, the procedure is to use a special paper. This one, still closed after 150 years. I will open it when I will try to do the copy. And you have to write on it with a special ink. This one, I think. Or could be also this. Then you have to clean the matrix so created with clean water using this cup. Then you lay the matrix so prepared on a pad impregnated with some chemicals. You prepare the sheet of paper, wetting it with a damping solution prepared in this jar using this powder. And you place it in this folder, pressing it with a pad. Then you place the sheet of paper on the matrix and you press it. So the chemical contained in the pad is forced through the lines of writing and brought in contact with the paper prepared for printing, forming the copy. And after 96 steps, using the pressure, you have the copy. For sure, humans can invent a better technology, and they did it, as we will see. In this letter of around 1880, a commercial agent of Zucato Copiers, writing with wonderful calligraphy to a customer, defined his first papyrograph copying method, an invention which stands unrivaled as assistant for the promotion of dispatch of business of all kinds. Notice letters can be circulated with a rapidity and economy truly surprising. In fact, its importance for business purpose cannot be overestimated. And he was right. Doing copies is of capital importance. At the end of the 19th century and at the beginning of the 20th century, it was also used this device, the copia lettere. This one is a very old copying device. In Italian, copia lettere means to copy a letter of correspondence. It was used to do a copy of the letter, documents and invoices sent by a company by mail. There is a drawer for accessories. And an extractable shelf, maybe to prepare the letter for the copy. And the press itself, with two handles to turn the screw and tighten the press. Letters and documents were written with ink enriched with glycerin glucose. Then these documents were pressed against transparent paper with a moist cloth. Within a few minutes, the humidity of the cloth passes through the tissue paper, dissolving the underlying original ink, which is reproduced on the tissue paper with which it's now in contact. There is already the video in this channel with the demonstration of how to print a copy with this device. The link is in the description. This one is the automatic cyclostyle from 1897. It has its original wood case. This is the blocking mechanism, where a rail model of the early copying history. It's a legendary early mechanic diaphragm copying machine by David Gestetner, London, for stencils. It was designed to print 2000 copies from a single matrix at a speed of 1200 copies per hour, very fast. I fix the crank. The roller is very worn. This crank moves the carriage on this plate and the roller should ink the paper, I think. At the moment I don't know how it works. Anyone know? I'd like to make a video on this while doing a copy. But it still moves nicely. There is a good coordination between all the moving parts. This one is Le Pardigraphe Toulon, France, a duplicator for manuscripts on glass plate. Very nice casing, with a nice logo. It's from the beginning of 20th century. It's a press, you can open it like this. Also here a wonderful writing on the plate. There were many similar duplicators at the beginning of last century. They were portable and cheap. The printing technology is similar to the lithography. There is still an old writing. It's written on the contrary. I can read it on a mirror. I studied French at school. It's a blessing from the French saint Vincent de Paul. Maybe I don't catch some word, but I think it says, May the child Lord bestow upon you his best blessings and accompany all your effort with his grace. It worked like this. The opal glass plate is treated with grease. Then a drawing with ammonia ink is made on paper with a brush or pen and is pressed onto this grease-treated opal glass plate. Where the ink etches away the grease, the glass plate later accepts the printing ink and repels the remaining grease. Multiple prints can be made from the inked plate. This one is a Ronio number 5 from Great Britain. It's from around 1910. It has a tin lid. It's a single cylinder duplicator using a stencil made with paper waxed. I open it. There is still an old matrix on the cylinder. It has an internal inking mechanism. It is turned by hand. You put the paper here. You rotate the cylinder with a crank, and the matrix of the cylinder print many copies. I will do soon a video dedicated to this. This one is the King's Copier from around 1920. It's a British patent. It's in a card box with the original instructions. It comes also with some packs of waxed paper to prepare the stencil to be used with this manual copier. There is also this short manual. This is the writing plate to write on the stencil. You place the stencil on it and you can use a pen like this. The pen removes the wax so the ink can go through the paper. Then, using this brush, you wet the cylinder of the device with the ink and you put the stencil you prepared before on the cylinder. You secure it with these hooks. The manual tells you can do till 400 copies with one inking. And you pass the roller on the paper. Very easy to use. This one is a Gestetner model real, could be dated from around 1922 to 1929. Gestetner is one of the most famous manufacturers of cyclostyles. Mimeographs were very common in the offices from the 1920s to the 1970s. This mimeograph relied on a master page, a matrix like this, that had the typing characters stenciled out. The matrix is a paper sheet covered of wax. Have you ever noticed on the old typewriter there is a position for no color for the ribbon? One of the uses is this, to prepare the matrix for mimeographs. When you type on this waxed paper, the typing character or the typewriter removes the wax from the paper, allowing the ink to go through. You could also use a special pens like this to draw something. The resulting sheet, called matrix, was hooked to the cylinder of the printing machine. The rotation mechanism of the cylinder synchronized the dragging of the empty sheet of paper and pressed the matrix between two rollers. It's the same principle of the Ronio 5 we saw before. One of these rollers was covered with the appropriate thick and oily ink, and the ink was transferred only to the parts without wax of the paper sheet. This is an old SADA 15 mimeograph, similar to the Gestetner. It's an Italian manufacturer founded in Milano, Italy, in 1927. SADA was still working in the 1970s, doing also alcohol duplicator like this, and the strange photographic duplicator. Also this uses a matrix, and in the end the matrix is the same we saw on the Ronio and the Gestetner. It works the same of the Gestetner. The lever moves the roller, and the matrix is pressed against the sheet of paper, thus doing the copy. This one is a simple printing press for visiting cards and little paper sheets. It's from around the 1950s. You put the card here, there is a stamp here, and the roller for inking the stamp. Very simple. This one is a Dupleco 960. It's an alcohol duplicator. Likewise, the old mimeograph, there is a rotating cylinder and there is a lever for the rotation of the cylinder. Alcohol duplication is a method of reproduction documents by transferring ink via an alcohol-based solution. This technology had a great success in the second half of the 20th century, particularly in the field of education. The technology for using directly the paper as an inking medium actually is very old. It has been conceived by William Ritzfeld in 1923. It's also much cheaper and easier to use than the mimeograph. It still works and do copies. There is a video in this channel if you want to see how it works. The link is in the description. Dupleco in the 1970s did a lot of models of these duplicators. Also very fun devices like this. This one is a Olivetti Copia 7025, a copia from 1990s. A lot of road has been made after the papyrograph. It's already a modern copier. There is a photostatic drum who creates the design to print. Then the design is transferred to the paper and cooked by two rollers. One of them is heated by a lamp. It is based on a Canon model. Olivetti at those times didn't produce copiers and branded the Canon instead. And in the end, these are the modern copiers you have in the office. They can be connected to computers and internet, and they do a lot of smart things. It's very efficient, but the mimeograph is much more sexy, and also, who didn't appreciate a steampunk device in his office?